episode 94 of the Tea and Possibilities podcast. I'm Nikki and this is a podcast all about knitting, crochet and making all the things here in Northwest London. I'm back. Are you shocked? I'm a bit shocked, to be honest. I've actually got a semi-busy weekend ahead of me. Tomorrow is Saturday. This is Friday afternoon. I finished work about 40 minutes ago. Tomorrow I am going to see Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness at about lunchtime, and then I'm going out for a couple of drinks for a friend's birthday, and I thought, oh, I can podcast on Sunday. But you know what? I kind of want to just go for a run, have a really long soak, and just knit all day on Sunday and kind of watch some YouTube stuff, listen to some podcasts, and just have a very indulgent day. And that is why I'm here with you on a Friday afternoon, because if I do it now, then I don't have to do it on Sunday. And I really enjoyed the last podcast. I enjoyed the doing of it. I enjoyed the editing, weirdly. And, you know, I enjoy getting back to all of your comments. So here I am again. There hasn't been a vlog. I'm kind of still ticking away about what I would do in a vlog, but I am working on that, so hopefully there will be something out while I'm away, because I am due to go away on Wednesday to Costa Rica, so I will be letting you know all about that in the next episode. Gosh, that was a lot of just babble. I'm really sorry. Clearly out of practice. Links is what I should be talking about, because everything I mention in today's podcast I will link just down below. Where possible, I will include non-Ravelry links, and everything I link to will be marked very clearly Ravelry or non-Ravelry. So depending on whether you can use Ravelry or not, hopefully that should make life a little bit easier for you. I will also be linking just down below to my Ko-fi account, so if you would like to buy me a cup of tea or a chai latte. Actually, I've had two chai lattes in the last week and they're really delicious. So a chai latte, if you'd like to buy me one of those, you can donate to my Ko-fi just down there. To everybody who has already donated and has donated since the last episode, thank you. I really do appreciate it. I got myself some gelato on yesterday, actually, Thursday evening. I went for a walk, I got some gelato, hazelnut and coffee. So I'm gonna say thank you for that. And while we are on the subject of gratitude, if you are a new viewer, thank you very much for giving the podcast a shot and welcome. I really hope you enjoy it. And to my returning viewers, an extra special thank you. I always really appreciate you coming back episode after episode, especially when I'm a little bit, ooh, when it comes to the uploading. Now today's tea is in my Le Creuset mug. It looks like my plant's inside it, but it's actually not. I love this mug. Look how cheerful it is, such a sunny yellow. And I love the shade of yellow it is down here. I don't know if it's picking up as well on the camera, and then it fades up to a more lemony color. The only thing wrong with this mug is it's not as big as my California mug that Caroline of Dundonit gave me, my bucket of tea. But I love the mug. So the only thing it could be is bigger. And today's tea, so good, is nettle, and it is by Trigothnan Tea. I've got the box. Here's the box. Trigothnan Tea. Trigothnan is one of my favourite tea purveyors, companies, brands is the word I was looking for. Nettle by Trigothnan is one that I will always buy. Another one that I really love is Cozy Tea. Cozy Tea's Earl Grey is one of my favourite Earl Greys in the world. I used to get, there was a knitting company, a UK-based knitting company that always included a Cozy Tea in their parcels. Meadow Yarns, I think it might have been. And that's how I discovered Cozy Tea. And I actually haven't found any Cozy Tea stockists online. I probably should take a much better look than I have done. But I do need to track that down. But this is not Cozy Tea, this is not Earl Grey for a change. It is nettle tea, and it's just delicious. It's kind of got a French, it's got a freshness that's kind of reminiscent of peppermint, but without that kind of toothpaste-y taste. So I highly recommend Trigothnan generally, their nettle tea in particular. I should also, before I go on, just mention that I am wearing a hand knit, though not hand knit by me. This is the Rosemont cardigan. I think I will check that and make sure it's correct on the screen. And it is knit out of Knit Picks Wool of the Andes, although I'm not sure what colour. And this was donated to me by the lovely Jude of the Stranded podcast. And I have lived in this. I think he donated it to me when I went to visit at the beginning of 2020, which I think was the last time I went anywhere before the pandemic. And because it was a bit chilly because Scotland, he lent me this and then said, you know what? You look good in it, you can keep it. Which I have lived and died in this thing. I love it. It does have an issue with the shoulders. I think plenty of people have talked about. But I really, really love it. It's just so cozy and I love just throwing it on and snuggling in. And actually, I thought I was chilly and it's not as chilly as I thought. So I might just whip this off halfway through the episode, but we'll see. Now, that was a great deal of blather and so much for me wanting to do like a short episode that I could edit quickly, but hey, it is what it is. But let's move on now to Whipped Up. Lie. There isn't a huge amount to talk about in Whipped Up. It was always going to be hard following an episode that came along after several months of hiatus. There are a lot of finished objects, not as many as there should have been. Although, you know, who says how many there should be? Nobody is keeping score. You know, there's not a competition, it's not a race, but because I lost my mojo for a while there wasn't as much knitting to show for that time as there normally would be. But there was still quite a lot of faux, and there are no faux at all this episode. But what I do have is a whip. Actually, I completely lied. It's not just a whip, it's a hoe. I completely forgot that I finished one. Look, it's been a really long week. I'm quite tired. I'm really tired. So yeah, forgive me, but it's a hoe. This is the Fab Funky Fibres self-striping sock in the Mr. Smith colourway, and the heels, toes and cuffs are knit out of Ripples Handcrafts in the Sullivan base in the Rubenberry colourway. And I am reliably informed that this is a Doctor Who colourway. Because I remember saying on the last episode, I don't know what Mr. Smith is referring to, what is the reference, somebody help me. And a very kind viewer did let me know that it is a Doctor Who reference, which makes sense because John Smith is his human pseudonym for when he is, you know, pretending not to be a Time Lord. And I don't know, looking at it in the kind of screeny thing, bearing in mind I don't have my glasses on, so all I can see are shapes and colours, it does have a little bit more of a Doctor Who kind of colouriness than I originally picked up on. However, they're not Christmas socks. Now, these are currently on my Ravelry as Christmas socks number 13. And they're not, are they? They're not. I mean, as much as I've tried with the red heels, toes and cuffs, and we've got the greens and a red in there, these are not Christmassy enough. So I think they are going to be removed from Christmas sock status and just moved into the normal sock drawer. Although having said that, my nan has been eyeballing them a little bit. So who knows whose sock drawer they will end up in. But I do have a hoe. And this is where I am on the second sock. So heel is in, gusset is done, and it's now just cruising on down the foot until I get to the toe. So I'm gonna get this finished this weekend. It's gonna be kind of my Sunday project, is to get that finished while I watch things and I have a little listen to things. I've got some really cool history podcasts downloaded. I've got an episode of The Rest is History that is about Merlin's Britain, which is just spot on for me. I am very, very happy and I'm really looking forward to listening to that. And I'll be working on this as I do so. So yeah, really lovely sock. I was like, what am I trying to say? Really lovely yarn. So yeah, really lovely yarn, really beautiful hand, gorgeous colours, really, really saturated. Doesn't go into my Christmas box of socks, which is a shame, but gorgeous pair of socks nonetheless, and will really brighten up a very grim grey day. Now, the last episode was called Monogamish for a reason, and that reason is that I have been pretty much monogamous up until that episode, and I continue to be. Now, the issue that I had, I'm gonna grab my tea. The issue that I had over the weekend, it was a bank holiday weekend here in the UK. And as I mentioned on my last episode, I was going to spend it in Vienna. So I flew out on Friday evening after work. I was there Saturday, Sunday, and I flew back Monday morning, which was great. It gave me time to get home slightly late because there was a delay, do a little bit of life admin, have a nap, and kind of get back on top of things ready for the week ahead. But because I was only going for the weekend, I only took hand luggage, so I didn't take my knitting. Now, I don't like risking taking my knitting on planes. I've heard all good things that you can, that if you take interchangeables or wooden ones, put them in a pencil case, put a wooden one in your hair, you know, you'll be fine. I have these on fixed metal chowgus, and I just didn't have the time because last week was super crazy. In fact, last week and this week have been super crazy because I'm going to be away very shortly for about 2 weeks. So I'm kind of doing my usual workload plus a little bit extra to make sure things are covered while I'm away. And I just didn't have the headspace to transfer it onto new needles, find new needles, all of that. So I left it at home. So I got no knitting done. I got a lot of reading done, but not a lot of knitting, which kind of is why I don't have that much to show. However, my flight to Costa Rica is something like 10 or 12 hours, and that's a really long time. And I've checked and there's some good films to watch. I have downloaded the second and third in the trilogy that I'm reading. So I am fully prepared for a long haul flight. I have also downloaded a few more podcasts, more than I'll get through this weekend. So I'm really stocked up there. I'm gonna charge up my overhead headphones. They're not noise cancelling, but they do have like the pads. So they block out a little bit more noise than just the kind of in-ear ones. But I really want to be able to knit. If I'm going to listen to a podcast or I'm going to watch a film, I like my hands to be busy. But I also don't want to risk having my needles taken away from me, even if they are interchangeable. So that is a very long-winded way of coming on to my next thing that I'm going to share, which is that yes, I bought more yarn. So a friend of mine recommended that I could crochet because even if they took my crochet hook away, if I put a crochet hook in my checked luggage as well as in my hand luggage, I will still be able to work on this over my holiday. I can try and work on it on the way back. So I decided to get some yarn for a crochet project. Now, my last crochet garment did not go so well. I have donated the yarn to my nan. I just don't think chunky yarn is my thing. It didn't work out very well, but I'm gonna have a go at doing the Gigi cardigan by Holly Woodward. Now she has crocheted hers in, I believe, Stylecraft DK, but I decided I wanted to do mine in cotton. So I went for Paintbox Cotton DK. Now for those of you who don't know, I used to work at Love Knitting, which is where you get Paintbox from. So I am very familiar with Paintbox. I'm very familiar with how it feels. Cotton is a little bit harder on the hands than wool would be, or silk, or alpaca. But I actually really love how the Paintbox feels. It's very soft, it knits up beautifully. So I decided, here we go, I'm gonna make this cardigan. Now the great thing about it is that it is made up in little squares, so I can work on little squares. My seatmate won't, you know, be disturbed by me wrangling anything humongous. I can just work on little squares as I'm listening or watching something. And unfortunately, she didn't put in the colours that she used. And I think she's got two colourways in the pattern, and one is like a creamy colour as the main colour with different colours, and one is a grey version. So I just kind of tried to get as close to the colours she used as possible. So we've got a good blend of colourful colours for the centres, and then I've got this kind of peachy caramel to do the main body with. I just think it's going to be a lot more neutral than going for like a black, for example. I think the black might be too heavy. Whereas I'm doing this in cotton, I'm thinking it'd be a much lighter summer weight kind of wear. So that is my plan. I want to familiarize myself with the pattern over the weekend, get a few squares done so that I can fill up my hand luggage, ridiculous, with Cotton DK and just work on some squares. There will be a couple of beach days. We are going to be doing a lot of exploring while we're there, because obviously, fantastic country. I don't just want to go and sit on the beach. But we will have a couple of kind of beach days, and I'm not very good at just laying on the beach. So I could even work on a couple of squares there. So not a lot to show. More planning than actual progress. But you know what, that's part of the fun. And I think buying that and recently buying the yarn for the Lois piano shawl really shows that my mojo is coming back. And actually I do want to cast on, my weekend's getting busier. I do want to wind up and cast on the Lois piano shawl this weekend. Because I just think that would be a really nice thing to come home to. So I think what I'm probably gonna do is finish the sock, and rather than cast on another sock, which is what I generally tend to do, cast on my Lois piano shawl instead, and then get a little bit going on that, get a really good chunk of my crochet cardigan done on the flights, and then I come back and there's a larger project waiting for me. I'll probably then cast on a sock. And this is sounding a lot like I've got mojo and mojo to spare. So we'll see. But I'm very excited by these projects, which is something I haven't felt in a long time. So, yay! But honestly, this is the most excited I've been about various projects in quite a while. So I'm very excited by that, which is all good news. So having covered everything that I am working on and that I plan to work on, let's move on to knit and natter. I was away in Vienna this past weekend. It's the second time I've been. I visited my friend who lives there before the pandemic. It would have been summer 2019 because we went swimming in the Danube, and it wasn't quite warm enough for that this time round. But yeah, we went swimming and had a fantastic time, and I think the city is absolutely beautiful. And then my friends had the great idea that we should go and visit her now that we were allowed to. Obviously, we haven't seen each other for like 2 years, getting on for 3 years, which is a really long time. And it was just fantastic. A group of us went, there were about six of us all together, and it was like we'd never been apart, and it was absolutely wonderful. And the first morning we had breakfast. She said it was brunch, but it was at 9:30, so it was definitely breakfast, at the top of an aquarium, which had this 365 view of the city, which was absolutely amazing. Such a gorgeous city, I cannot get over it. And then we went for a really nice stroll around the city. We had lunch by the canal and just had some drinks before going on for dinner. Very, very chill, just lots of catching up, lots of walking, and just enjoying this fantastic city. And then on the Sunday, we were due to go to a winery, but unfortunately it wasn't quite the sunny, warm day that it had been the day before. It was a bit more drizzly. So we caught the U-Bahn, my German, my Austrian, sorry, is terrible. The tube, which was actually really cool. It's a lot wider and feels more spacious than the London tube. And I thought that the map was pretty clear. Like if I hadn't had somebody there guiding me, I probably could have found my way myself. With a little bit of trial and error, which is pretty cool. But we went to see the Empress Sisi's palace, Schönbrunn, I think it's called, and I'm butchering that and I'm really sorry, but it is gorgeous. We didn't pay to go inside, we just went around the grounds, and oh my goodness, such an amazing garden. Like there was this wisteria walk where we got loads of pictures, there was this epic fountain that we saw before we headed off to get some food. We had schnitzels are great, really good, and honestly I've never seen anything like it. It was kind of like Hampton Court Palace but better. And I think I said this when I went to Vienna the first time, I went to the Natural History Museum there, and I actually think the way they displayed, this is so dorky, the way they displayed their dinosaurs was a lot better than the Natural History Museum in London. And I say that as a very big fan of the Natural History Museum in London. And I kind of think the Schönbrunn, Emperor Sisi's palace, had even better gardens than Hampton Court. Absolutely gorgeous. I really, really recommend, if you are in Vienna, to go and have a look. They are stunning, fantastic for photography. So if you just want to get pictures with your mates, it's going to look great. And yeah, we just had a really nice time. And then we went and had a fantastically leisurely, kind of very, very late lunch, kind of early dinner, and at a little kind of pub around the corner from there. And we had schnitzels. We had this like a scrambled pancake for dessert, which was great. Really, really good. Oh, something else I did on the Saturday on our way to the canal to grab some sausage, as you do, because we went in Austria, which we had for lunch by the canal. But on my way there, I had, I believe the shop was called Fentonmeister, and they do these cones, so like an ice cream cone that's lined with chocolate, but they put coffee in it, and you drink the coffee and then you eat the cone, and it was so good. And you know me, I like tea over coffee. I think I've said before that when I get a takeaway drink, it tends to be coffee, because I'm not paying £2.50, £3, however much, for a tea bag and some water when I've got like an epic stash at home. I'm just not doing it. So, but this was particularly excellent. I really thought that it was gonna be like kind of a very fragile cone that was gonna fall apart. No, it was sturdy when I finished the coffee, which was really, really good, by the way. It had like, on one of the coffee bags, they had a little cat knitting. But I don't really drink coffee at home, so I didn't buy it. But when I'd had that, delicious, and then ate the waffle cone, and right at the end, like the little pointy bit was just filled with chocolate. Why aren't we doing that over here? I would get that all the time. It was so good. So get that. I'm gonna try and find out from her what it was called and put it on the bottom. But it was just like this little hole in the wall, so you couldn't go in and sit down. You just had to go up and order, and they handed it to you. It was really good. I will say that I was a little bit anxious about travelling. I've talked before about how my anxiety has gotten worse during the pandemic, and I was a little bit anxious because I haven't flown anywhere since I went to Italy in 2019. I went to Lake Como with a friend, haven't been anywhere since. No, I didn't fly to Scotland, I got the train. So yeah, that was the last time I got on a flight. So I was flying from Stansted, which is a nightmare to get to. So I was getting myself a little bit like, what time do I have to get there? Like, what if everyone's like off with COVID so that I can't get through security because there's not enough people? How long? And it was a little bit. And obviously, depending on where you go, the rules are different. So yeah, I was a little bit, oh, before I left. And it was absolutely fine. It was completely fine. And coming back was also fine, apart from I couldn't go through the European queue, which was sad. It's the first time that's happened, very sad. And I feel a lot more calm about Costa Rica on Wednesday, because I've done it. And I know it's not a big a deal, so it's fine, and it will be fine. But yeah, that's it. I just kind of wanted to tell you a little bit about my trip and to recommend the coffee in a waffle cone. Coffee in a waffle cone. Coffee and ice. It wasn't really an ice cream cone because it's very sturdy. But that, I wanted to recommend that. I wanted to recommend you go to Empress Sisi's palace and see the fantastic grounds, because honestly, really gorgeous. So yeah, go to Vienna. It's an absolutely gorgeous city. You know, all of us have lived or still live in London that went, and we all commented on just how much area it felt. London's quite an old city, it's very higgledy-piggledy, it can feel very narrow and very kind of overwhelming sometimes, whereas I found there was so much space and a lot of green space in Vienna, which I really appreciated. I do love London, I hasten to add. It is my hometown and I love her very much, but you know, that doesn't mean you can't appreciate when other places can do things better. So that's it for this week. I did kind of say it would be a pretty short one because I don't have much to show for myself. As I say, I've been away and I've been working flat out, so there hasn't been much making time, which is a shame, but you know what? I was very privileged to go away on a little trip and to have another trip coming up already, so I cannot complain. I'm really looking forward to, well, I'm not looking forward to coming back from my trip insofar as I'd have to start going back to work and stuff, but I'm looking forward to telling you about Costa Rica when I get back, and I'm hoping to do a little vlog as well. So there will be something for while I'm away, we hope. Don't hold me to it. Like I say, shoulda, woulda, coulda. You know, if it happens, it happens. But that's it for this week. I hope you are keeping well, keeping safe, and I will see you very soon for another cup of tea. Take care. Bye. Hello, and I've got crumbs.